The fines from the main corridor are added to the ones from the floor of the shaft. The dugout and the men who built it are coming into sharper focus. Alongside the predictable debris of war, some of the tools used by the men of 171.
One of the first things we came across was this short bulldog shovel. And as you can see, it's been cut down. These were made specially for the Royal Engineers to work in confined spaces.
It's about the right size for me, isn't it? And what about this shovel?
This is called a grafting tool. And as you can see, it's a different shape, and they both have different jobs. Mm. This was specifically designed to cut into the heavy, wet clay. And you'd literally cut it in and prise it out in blocks.
Is that an oil can?
Yeah, lovely, lovely little thing. You can see it's got the maker's mark still on it. Very visible.
Does that say K's patent?
That's right. And if you open it off, you can take a whiff.
Yeah, you can smell the oil, can't you?
First World War oil. Yeah. It's incredible, isn't it? That still work.
What's this big elaborate thing here?
That is a very important object. This is the filter off the original pump that was used to keep the dugout dry. And we've even got the liners, the metal liners from that pipe, which was probably canvas. The soils are so wet here that at times they would have to have men manually operating pumps 24 hours a day. It's a really nasty job, I would imagine.
So is that part of the pump?
I thought it was a lever that you would use to pump the machine, but it's too heavy. What this is from a railway line, and there was a railway running very close by here, and I think it's the lever that you would use to change the points on the tracks. And interestingly, I think the Royal Engineers, the guys building the dugout, have nicked this. They've scavenged it, and they've taken it downstairs because, if you feel it, it's actually a really good weight and would be very useful for driving in heavy timbers. It's like a big maul. So I think they've nicked that and then used it for a different purpose.
Are these bottles British or German?
These are very domestic to us, especially to me, because my hometown's on this one. This is a jar of Baird's pickles from Glasgow. We've also got a bottle of Cambridge relish. I don't know what that's probably some sort of anchovy sauce. And good old traditional HP sauce.
Hooray.
Great with your chips, but anything to give a little flavour to this really boring diet. And you would wash it all down with a drop of the local wine.
This is my...